Okay, so for the second quarter, our first lesson is the remainder to write. Okay, so we have the example here. For each of the following, divide the polynomial p of x. So this is the symbol for polynomial. We did not read this as px, but p of x. So that is the correct way of reading this, p of x. Then, aside from that, we have other symbols like g of x, h of x, f of x. So those are symbols for polynomial functions, okay? And then by the divisor, x minus c, then calculate for p of c. So p of c is the remainder. So p of c. Now we have four examples here, a, b, c, d. But I'm going to give you a separate example. So let's have p of x here is equals to x squared plus 2x minus 5. Then the divisor will be x plus 2. Okay. So now we are going to divide this, or we are going to find the remainder of this polynomial function, x squared plus 2x minus 5. Then our divisor is x plus 2. First thing to do is you need to equate the divisor to 0. When you say equate to 0, you are going to write it as x plus 2 equals to 0. So that is the way of equating it, okay? And then transpose positive 2 going to the right side. Then x is equals to negative 2. So once you transpose, you need to change the sign. If it is positive, so make it negative. If it is negative, as a negative sign, make it positive. So that's the rule in once we transpose it. Then there's a property we use. We use on that, we call it the property, ratio property of equality or subtraction property of equality. But the most common is transposition method. Okay, so yun ang ano nyo, bali kalimitan ginagawa ng mga math teachers na para mas padaling maintindihan. Okay, so our divisor now is x equals negative 2. So negative 2. Now, after finding negative 2, we are going to write down the solution on how to apply the remainder theorem. So we have p of negative 2 is equals to negative 2 squared plus 2 times negative 2 minus 5. So from here, we only replace negative 2 as values of x. So we have now negative 2, p of x, so p of negative 2. Then substitution. And then we have now negative 2 squared is how many?
4.
Okay, positive 4 or 4. Then plus 2 times negative 2. Okay, so we will use parenthesis or parenthesis times negative 2 or negative 4, then minus 5. So what will be the answer? So 4 plus negative 4, it will become now 0. Then the answer is minus 5. So meaning the remainder is equals to negative 5. So this is now the remainder. Okay. Now the question that, how will you check whether your remainder is correct? Negative, how many? Negative 5. So in our previous lesson, we studied about synthetic division, right? So let's do the synthetic division here. So in synthetic division, we just only use the or get the numerical coefficient, correct? So if this is the example, x squared plus 2x minus 5. So we have now 1, positive 2, then negative 5, correct? Then the divisor will be, what is the divisor?
Negative
2. So we are using synthetic division. Then bring down 1, 1 multiply negative 2, the answer is negative 2, then add 2 plus negative 2, 0, 0 times negative 2, 0, then add negative 5 plus 0. Okay, so this is now the remainder. So, which means they are equal, correct? So, if we will use this remainder theorem, we got negative 5 as our remainder. Then, also here, using the synthetic division, we have also negative 5 as our remainder. So, in answering number 1, I need this solution. You are going to write this solution in your notebook. Did you understand?
Yes, sir.
Okay? So, just copy the question, letter A, then solution. No need to write this, the synthetic solution, synthetic division. Only this one. In order to find the remainder, just use this solution. Okay? So, is it clear for number 1? Okay, so number 2. Organize your work in item number 1 by completing the table below. So this is the table. Now, in the second column, we have the dividend. So the symbol is P of X. So if you will use this example on the board, what is your answer in the first column? Anybody? Yes, Carmona.
Sir, will it include the P, or will it only be asking for the value of X in the dividend?
Only the value, the dividend. What is the dividend?
Sir, negative 2.
Is the dividend negative 2? Nice try.
Another?
Yes, Aurelio?
X squared plus 2X.
Okay, so we have now X squared.
Plus
2X. X squared plus 2X. Minus 5. So that is the answer. Okay, so this is our per hour sample. Then how about the divisor? X plus 2. Correct. This is the dividend, then this is the divisor. How about C? What is the value of C? Negative 2 is correct. So that is the value of C. Then, how about the quotient? When we say quotient, if you will remember, so if we will divide, we have the parts of the division, we have the dividend, we have the divisor, and the answer of the division process is quotient, okay? So, what is the answer here? Under this column. Okay, so later we will go back to this column. So let's proceed to the remainder. What's the remainder?
Negative 5.
Correct, negative 5. And how about the value of P of C? P of C is how many?
Negative
5. Okay, so if you have book, do you have? Can you read the one in the box, inside the box? Just read, go. So the remainder R is equals to P of C. So what is your answer here? Okay, so it's very clear that the answer is also negative 5. The remainder R is equals to P of C. Did you understand? So negative 5. Let's go back to function. So P of X here. What is your answer? Anybody? If we will divide x squared plus 2x minus 5 divided by x plus 2, what is the quotient? Is it 0? Is it x? So negative 2 is the negative 2 is the value of c, it's not the quotient. Okay, go. So the answer is here. Just look at the answer here.
Sir, 1, 2, and negative 5.
1, 2, and negative 5. Okay, nice try. Or else?
1015.
Okay, 1015. Another?
1, 0, -5.
Yes, but 2.
Sir, -2 and -5.
-2 and -5. Okay. Oh, any other answer?
0 and 2.
So just recall our previous lesson. So once we divide this, what is the function? And then? X plus 0. Okay, so I'm going to write now the answer. Oh, wala na ba? Wala na nga hahabol? Sure? Okay. So we have X minus 5 over X plus 2. Okay. So we did not include 0, x plus 0, because 0 has no value. Okay, no value. So only x. Since we use a synthetic there on the other side, we subtract 1 here in the exponent. 2 minus 1 is equals to 1. So that is why we have x here. Then minus 5, because the remainder has a negative sign, negative 5, then over the divisor. So that's the complete answer. Okay? So in your exam, I observe when you divide polynomials, yung last part, dividing, so some of the students write the final answer like this. So if that is the case, x minus 5 over x plus 2. So in writing your function, don't write this x minus 5 over x plus 2. You need to separate this. Okay? So that will be your remainder. In writing the remainder, just copy that divisor as your denominator. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So you are going to complete this table. This is the example. You are going to start at A, B, C, D. So complete this. And then once you completed the table, you need to answer number 3. What did you observe about the remainder and P of C? Okay, so you may start now. Go.